66-year-old Li Fangbing has lived in Yaojin village for 40 years.
It took me all those years of hard work to save up enough money to buy my house, but suddenly, in a matter of seconds that day, it was all gone.
At 2:28 in the afternoon, on May 12, 2008, a powerful earthquake struck about an hour's drive from Li's home in China's Sichuan province.
I quickly ran outside and started screaming for my husband to get up. That's when the house started to crumble.
54 other families in Yaojin lost everything that day.
I've never experienced such horror and sadness in my life.
Twelve months later, this village is anything but a place of horror and sadness. Thanks to a unique partnership between Operation Blessing and the Chinese government, this tiny corner of the earthquake zone is rising from the rubble. In an innovative approach, Operation Blessing adopted the entire village of Yaojin.
It's a huge commitment to make. An undertaking like this, it's a very expensive project.
We're not talking about one house.
No, it's not one house. It's 54 homes.
David Dark is overseeing Operation Blessing's work in Yaojin.
The villagers were living in temporary shelters in very bad conditions, and we knew we had to get them out of those and into new homes as quickly as possible.
10 months after the earthquake, in a grand celebration, a ceremonial key was handed over to the mayor of Yaojin. All 54 homes were rebuilt, and the villagers started to move in.
These new homes are nothing like what we had before. You spend the money to build up strong homes that can withstand another strong earthquake.
A couple of days ago, Zhu Shehui, a longtime resident of the village, threw a housewarming party for family, friends, and members of the Operation Blessing team.
We will never forget you guys. You did such a good thing. How can we ever repay you?
With so many parties to attend, Li Fangbing had to wait her turn to honor the Operation Blessing team.
When I think about the anniversary, I feel sad. But then I look around and see what has happened since, and I have so much to be thankful for. We could never afford to rebuild a new home, but Operation Blessing and this partnership has made this dream a reality.
Villagers spent this past week painting and putting the final touches to their new homes in preparation for today's anniversary.
I'm just helping this lady crack some of this concrete slab that's going to go along the side of her new home. You know, building one home for Operation Blessing is not really a huge undertaking, but building 54 homes for 54 families, that's another issue. Getting support from the local authorities is key, but also getting support from folks like these villagers is also critical.
Operation Blessing's president, Bill Horan, says it's remarkable to see how the villagers, along with local officials, the central government, and Operation Blessing, work together to make Yaojin a reality.
We all pushed in the same direction, and the result is evident. The result is a completely rebuilt village. It's risen up from the ashes.
And this got the attention of China's state-run news agencies. Today, during a primetime anniversary special, CCTV, the main television network, aired a documentary featuring Operation Blessing's Yaojin project. Bill Horan was a guest on the show.
This is so significant because hundreds of millions of Chinese people will for the first time get to see what Operation Blessing has done with our partnership to help the survivors of the earthquake.
Early in the week, Operation Blessing held a photo exhibit and press conference in Beijing, highlighting the work in Yaojin. Members of the national media and several top government officials were there.
I'm not just impressed that Operation Blessing built these houses, but now they're engaging in the next phase of restoration by starting a chicken farm and piggery business in the village that will help sustain long-term recovery.
Li Jiaoxing, a senior member of China's foreign affairs team and a former ambassador to the United States, hosted a dinner in honor of Operation Blessing. Operation Blessing is celebrating 10 years of humanitarian work in China this year. Horan says the Yaojin project is one more example of Operation Blessing's long-term commitment to helping the people of China.
The mayor of Yaojin put his hand on my shoulder and he said, "We've never seen love like this. We don't understand it. It must be God. It can't be human."
George Thomas, CBN News, Yaojin, China.